blessed be the name of the Lord.
So our generation must be very careful. Look at Matthew chapter number 5. Matthew chapter number 5. I'll read verse number 7 and 8. He says, the blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. He says, the blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. He says, the blessed are the peace. Start from verse number 5. I just want to read the Beatitudes so quickly. From verse number 5. Where you are? 5. He says, the blessed are the meek, they shall inherit the earth. 6. Let me stop here. The blessed are those who hunger and they that thirst, for they shall be filled. Hear me, child of God. One of the reasons why, even though we have been positioned in Christ but through salvation, one of the reasons why we have not seen the reality of what amongst us is because we lack hunger. It's because we lack hunger. Look at Isaiah chapter number 64, verse number 6 and 7. I'm interested in 7 because 6 will talk about filthy rags. Okay, let's start here. He says, about all like an unclean thing, all our righteousness is like filthy rags. We all fade. The mistress in verse number 7. He says, there is no one who calls on your name. There is no one who stirs himself to take hold of you. For you have hidden your face from us and you have consumed us. There is no one that calls on your name. There is no one that stirs himself. We are too comfortable. If we are not careful, the story of our life will be summarized by one man called Gehazi. Amen. Because if we don't have the hunger and the thirst, and that hunger and thirst is supposed to push us, is supposed to stir us, so that we can call on his name. Daniel was told, don't pray. But in the day that he was told that he should not pray, that if he prays, they will throw him into the lion's den. That same day he prayed 3 times. Because he understood that the destiny of an entire nation was resting on a man that could pray. So he could not be comfortable. There was the threat of being eaten up by the lions, but he could not be comfortable. Nothing will ever change while we are at the place of our comfort. Amos will prophesy to us in chapter number 6 and verse number 1, and he will say that, woe to the women that are comfortable. He talks of woe to those who are at ease in Zion and that trust in Mount Samaria. He's talking about the woe to the notable persons, those who are of the house of Israel, but they are comfortable and they are at ease in Zion. That they are not disturbed, they are not star, they are not challenged. Isaiah will say that no one calls on his name, no one stars themselves so that they can get grab hold of God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I want you to understand, there is more to church than what we have seen these 10, 20 years. There is more to God than what the preachers have told us. Because I believe with all my heart that God is a living God. It's not a historical figure. There's a difference between Vasco da Gama and Jehovah. Amen. There's a difference between men that have roamed this earth and they have a name, what they did, what they said. God is not like Martin Luther. I can tell you the statements and the philosophical statements of Martin Luther, but for Jehovah, it's not philosophical statements of yesterday. Even now, he's still speaking. Amen. God is not like the Mau Mau fighters, that the way they fought for us and they went upon Mount Kenya and they fought for our freedom, and that is why now we have Uhuru, that is not why we have Madaraka, that is what they did and they died. Our God is not dead. Our God is still alive. So if there will be a generation of a people that will not be at ease in Zion, if there be a generation of a people that will stir themselves up, whatever he did yesterday, we will see him doing it right now, because he does not change. Much of the healing we know is in the Bible. Much of the barrenness we know, that God blessed Hannah with a kid, God blessed the wife of Manoah that birthed, you know, Samson. Much of what we know, women that did not bear, women that could not give birth, most of them that we know, you don't know them from your village. You know them from the Bible. I don't know them from the city where I live. I know them in the Bible. But I want you to understand, the God that opened the barren wombs in the years ago, he is still alive even today.